Good afternoon, friends. Myself, M.A. Patil. I am here to taught you the subject, the Capstone Project Planning for the fifth semester for academic year 2020-21. So, this subject is allocated for a third year students for the fifth semester having a subject code 22050. The subject having an abbreviation that is a CPP, that is nothing but the Capstone Project Planning. In this subject, we are going to complete a progressive assessment and so many things. So, how to write a synopsis report or proposal report for a particular project. So, in detail, we are discussing in later on. So, first one, we discuss the examination scheme or the marking allocation for this subject. So, this subject, according to the MSPT curriculum, in examination scheme, they are given a 25 marks for 8 semester exam and a progressive assessment having a 25 marks. So, in this progressive assessments, you have to complete a proposal, you have to analyze the day-by-day attendance, the behavior of the students, and the literature review, how the all project team should tackle the entire project. So, the involvement of the students. So, this is the continuous observations throughout the semester. So, depending upon that, we are giving 25 marks for a progressive assessment. So, in details, we are discussing later on, no problem. So, in this end semester exams, you have to face the oral. You have to face the oral and you have to prepare the PPT also. So, on the basis of that, how to defend your oral, according to that, you have to give the 25 marks. So, first one, why this subject is included in your syllabus for the fifth semester? So, first we discuss regarding that CPP. So, CPP, nothing but the Capstone Project Planning. So, what is nothing but the project? So many things are overcome if you are considering this name project. Some students in past 2 or 3 years, if you are seeing the batch, I am asking the students what is the mean by project. So many students are giving me share so many ideas regarding this project. So, the project is nothing but you have to do something innovative or you have to come up with a certain solution that will be helpful for a society, that will be solve a certain problems. It doesn't mean, a project is doesn't mean that should be do a certain fast things and you have to spend a so much large amount of money for that. It doesn't mean that. It will be only find some solution for a particular existing problem. That is very important. It may be small. The problem should be small, no problem. But you have to improve, you have to apply your own knowledge, you have to apply your own skill, you have to solve how you are going to tackle these particular things or the problem. That is very important. As far as considering a course outcome of this particular subject, or they are giving a certain points to introduce this subject for this semester for third year mechanical. So, we are going to focus on. So, So what type of expected or expectations from students they are expecting as far as concerning this subject, now we are going to focus that. So students should be initiative, confidence, they should be skilled or ability to tackle the problem. They want to improve your skill by handling any project type of work. They want how the students are tackle the problem, that is very important. Then how the students are apply their own logic. Then the students' ability to do work. Then improvement of teamwork. So these are just some points. These are some important points that we improve under this particular subject in a capstone project and subject. So skill, very important. So you taught so many subjects in last 2 years. So it will be math, mathematics, graphics, then SOM, TOM. For this semester or next semester you also complete so many subjects, that is nothing, automobile engineering, metrology and quality control and design. So you all learn all these subjects in throughout this year, last 2 years or in this fifth semester. So by utilizing the knowledge of this all these theoretical subjects, so you have apply your own logic, you are applying your own skill, and how to finish this project. So this is nothing but the one of the type, the project assignment is nothing but the we are going to check these parameters of individual students. How the students are applying the skill, how the students are handling or tackle the problems, then that should be overcome while we are completing the project. How the students are applied the logic to solve the problems, to identify the solutions, or fabricate if some design is required or manufacturing is required for a particular project. So how the student should handle that things, then fabrication or manufacturing or whatever, okay, if any software required or any design required to draw the design on CAD software, all these things. Then the ability to do work. So what initiative that students should be take amongst the group to complete the project. So that is very the involvement of that students, individual students in a group. That parameter we are going to observe throughout this semester under this curriculum or under this project or subject. And the teamwork. Very important parameters required, teamwork for industry. So many industry, so any type of work we are going to complete or big achievements regarding any big projects we are going to complete with the help of this teamwork. So teamwork is observed in this particular project. So these are the some points for the in this curriculum. Whenever you are completing this project or the proposal or the entire project work, so these skills are enhanced of each and every students, and we are going to focus on these parameters. So students should able to get or student should able to enhance these skills while completing the project, while planning the project. So for this fifth semester, or if you consider the total project, so that will be divided into same, so fifth and sixth semester. So for this fifth semester they are doing a CPP, and for sixth semester they are doing a abbreviation CPE. CPE is nothing but the capstone project execution. And CPP is nothing but you already know, capstone project. Now we are doing this one for fifth semester. In next semester we are doing this one. So you have to execute the plan, you have to actually prepare the project, you have to prepare physical model or whatever, analysis type, experiment type, any type of project, you actually have to finish in a sixth semester. But before that, to execute this project, what are the requirements, what are the plans, what are the planning requirement to execute this project in next semester, all these plannings are done in the fifth semester. In this planning, so many things are overcome, so many problems you are going to face. Finalize the title. First you have to identify five problems, then you have to finalize the problem. Then one by one, we are doing so many things and we are come up with a certain title. Or to come up with a certain problem and finalize the title. So all these types of planning, we have to so many things you have to complete in this semester. First we are going to only focus on this CPP, and next semester we are focus on the CPE. So initially these are the things you have to this is the generalized idea or overview of this particular project. Now if you are considering the course outcomes of a capstone project planning for this subject, so you must be in a curriculum, they are giving a COs, course outcomes for a subject. So one by one we are discussing all the COs of this project CP. So first one that is find tasks or problems. First CO, giving it CO A, find tasks or problem, identify a problem. So this is the first CO, course outcome. So there are so many COs, one by one we are discussing. Among that, this is the first one, find task or problem. What is nothing but the task? What is nothing but the problem? So if you do the literature, check out the, or if you are referring a past projects which are already done by our past students from last 8 years, if you are read that all the projects, if you are analyze their all the projects reports, or if you are referring to all the project reports, or if you search a papers in a reputed journals with the help of a internet online, if you are visiting any industry and they are facing some problems regarding any manufacturing system or any experimental setup they are having available in their campus. So any industry or any institute or any a marketing company also we are going to consider. So they are facing, or any society, we are facing a certain problems, day by day problems. So these are the small problems we are find out by surveying industry, by surveying market, by surveying any firm. And these problems we have to identify, first one. And so many problems are overcome when you are visit to so many things. So we are find out, or we are come with so many problems, then we are going to choose a particular problem. So that problem or task is nothing but your project or your project title. So before that, finalizing that problem, first you have to analyze that, or you have to know that this problem is solved within this particular year. So many resources are required to solve these problems. You have to check whether the resources are available, whether the consumer materials are available, whether the design softwares are available, whether the resource persons are available. So you have to check the each and everything, whether the project batch is complete or this or tackle this particular problem and come with a certain solution, and that solution is nothing that should be provided to that industry and taken out the completion later. So first, whether you are completing this problem, whether the price we are going to spend to solve that problem, whether that will be affordable to particular student, you have to check that. So resource person, consumer material, the financial problem, the infrastructure available in the institute. So you have to focus on that, all these things, and check out whether we are finalized this particular or tackle this particular problem, or that will be finalized the title. So on the basis of that, all these things, on the basis of all these things, you have to first find out the task or problem, or define the problem, or it also called as a finalize the project title. The title, identification of the title or finalizing the title is very important. So what you have to do to find out these things, first you have to do a literature review, you have to go through the internet, you have to search the projects, small projects. You have to refer the last 8-year project which is available in our department as well as in library, central library. So what they are already did or some work that is available, that should be mentioned in a future scope, under a future scope point in a project report, so that you have to read it. So the scope of projects you have to find out, and then you have to work on that. So refer the project reports available in department, okay? And if you are visiting any industry for a sponsored project, then they are facing some problems. You have to analyze that problem, and then you have to decide whether that problem should be completed from your side. Or you have to give the solution for that problem, and then you have to sponsor that project by that company. So this is nothing but identification of the task or problem to finalize the project under a CPP. That is your course outcome, first course outcome for this subject. That is course outcome A, small letter. The second one, they are given, the course outcome second one is the collect the information to solve the problem. Collect the information to solve the problem. So collecting information. Once you find the problem, then so many things are required. We already discussed, so many things are required. It should be required a material, should be required software, it should be required a fabrication work, should be required a machine, should be required a man or resource person. So many things are required. So whether it should be available, whether that material or these all these new resources are available with us, we may have to check that. Some problems are already on some problems, someone is already do a certain work. So you have to find out that work on a literature review by reading some certain journals or papers or publications through internet. So there is a journals, some journals are available in our degree library also. So if you want, you access that journal or refer that journal in degree library. So all diploma students have access to use that degree library or each journal also. So you have to get some information from that journal also. You have to get information from internet also. You have to get some information or to visit a particular resource person, so that you will be expertizing this particular area. So that in that area means you have to choose a certain problem, in that problem is regarding the design one, that will be regarding with the experimental one, that will be regarding with the GCAN fixture type, whatever. So you have to find, you have to search the expertise person regarding that area. So that type of information, whether your project is completed from your side in this particular academic year, you have to check that. And that confidence level will build up after completion or after collecting of information only. So this task is very important. What happened? In last year, some project was finalized their title and their work out throughout the semester on that project. After 4 months, they facing that some of these problems. We didn't get a particular material, we didn't get a certain consumer material, or if that material also having that material is costlier also, so we can't afford that price. So after 4 months, they are going to change the title. So what is the problem? If you are changing the title, once again you have to do a work from a scratch, from zero. And already 4 months are over. So that will be build up a pressure on that particular group or student. So that project is not completed in that particular time. So first problem and the information collection, whether that problem is handled or not, that is very important. That is nothing but the project selection is very important. So you have to discuss this, all these things with your guide. Already guides are allocated, you know your guide, you contact your guide by telephonic information, by telephone, or by email, through email. Or if you are visible, then visit to college and concern with guide. So you have to finalize this title before this 20 October 2020. So all the students take the follow-up of your guide and do these things. So finalize your title of project before the 20 October. After collecting information, once you feel that or confidence, your confidence is built up, then we are moved to next one or next CO. And that CO number C. So that is the CO number C. What is that? That is relevant solutions. Relevant solutions. Relevant solutions. What is nothing but the relevant solution? Once you find the problem, you have built up the confidence by collecting information. So after that, you know, on the basis of information, you know this problem gets solved on the basis of certain things. That things are nothing but the solution. The one, for a particular one problem, there are a number of solutions. 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever. To complete this problem, to complete your project, there are so many ways to complete. So there are so many solutions available. Okay. So once you have to find out the solutions, the number of solutions. Suppose there are 4 solutions to solve a particular project or to solve a problem. Then you have to analyze that which solution is the best one. Among these 4 solutions, which one is the best one? What is nothing but the best? Best is nothing but the whether we are applying the solution number 1, 2, 3 or 4. You have to decide that. Is it feasible? Means, feasible means easily available. Suppose some technology is required to complete the particular task in a project. That technology is available with us, suppose in the in solution, a particular solution, we require a CNC machine. Whether the CNC machine is available to manufacture a particular component in your project? Yes. The answer is yes. The CNC machine is available in shared institute of technology. So, that is feasibility. Means once solution is analyzed and that should be okay and that is available 24 hours. So that will be build up a confidence to solve the problem. So Europa R is like that. In our sense, if you for a particular if you want to complete a certain drawing, whether the CAD softwares are available in your lab,
yes.
So solid modeling. So CAD software is AutoCAD is there, CATIA is there. Solid modeling is there. These are the certain CAD softwares are also available in our lab. So that's that problem is also there. So like that.
You have to check the resources, all these resources. You have to check the entire relevant solutions.
What are the technologies required? What are the manufacturing machines are required? What are which resources and persons are required? Okay. So these comes under a certain solution. These are the solutions. By getting these solutions, we are completing our title of project. So, n number of solutions if you are getting, then you have to focus the relevant one. The relevant means what? Easier solution. You have to find out and that you have to finalize. Suppose the second number solution is most easier one and that we are going to apply to solve the problem. Then we are going to apply the solve the problem. So likewise, you have to analyze the relevant solution or the most feasible or most easier solution and that will be solve your problem. That is your CO course of the C. Okay. Then the next one, that is the D. Ethical issues. You have to consider some certain ethical issues as far as considering your project. Ethical issues means what? If you are completing your project, suppose you have to give one engine, but that should be produced carbon dioxide as compared to the bike available in the market. The CO exhausted from your engine is so hazardous as compared to the other bikes, then that is nothing but the issues that will create issues, social issues that will create a pollution that is hazardous to human being. So these types of issues are overcome whenever you are completing your project. So before some problems regarding the ethical issues or the problems regarding the societies, you have to consider these issues before selecting the project. So that is very very important. Some in certain cases, if your project is big one, that should be going to patent also. Projects are also going to patent. So at that time, they are considering all these things. At that particular one, if you are commercializing your project, at that time you have to face these problems. So you consider this ethical issue factor while finalize your project title. That is your CO, course outcome B. Then impact of project on society. That is social factor you have to consider. Whether your project is beneficial to a society, whether that should be beneficial to any organization, you have to solve a particular problem of a day-to-day life problem that will be faced by society. Any small thing, whatever. Is a project is doesn't mean you have to finish or you have to complete or you have to solve the big problem that will be already faces the human beings from last so many decades. That doesn't mean you have to take a small problems by survey, and that will be when you solve that will be help to society. That will be helpful to society. So society factor. So if you are minimize the pollution, okay, then that is the you are help to society. So help by minimizing the CO problem, you help by default the society. So like these certain points you have to consider. How it should be helpful to society, which type of problems we are going to solve, what are the number of solutions, what we are going to finally choose, and that will be helpful to society. So these factors you have to consider by selecting a problem. That is your COE. COE. Then next one, prepare a project proposal. So once you go through all these things, you have to finally prepare a project proposal. That is your last PDF, project proposal. Once you go through all these problems, you have to write a proposal. What is the proposal? How we are going to select the problems, you have to write down. Then which literature, which information we are going to collect. Then how the data you have to plan. Then the year number of solutions, we already decided that. From that, which one is the better one, that you have to plot on the paper. Then if there is any ethical issue or societal issue, you have to mention in that. And so 3 to 4 pages or 5 pages proposal you have to write down your project. How we are going to finish the project? Which type of solutions are available? Which type of consumable material is required?